and censor speech, but that's what California has come to. My name is Karen England. I'm the executive director of Capital Resource Institute. We are one of the co-sponsors of this rally, helping to lead the way to fight this bill. I'm thankful for all the speakers before us. As you see, many lives have been changed, and if AB 2943 was enacted, it would prohibit these people from truly being able to change their lives. So the first thing I want to do is some housekeeping. We have restrooms in the back, tables with signs, and different co-sponsors' information over there if you want to know who's been battling this bill. You can go over there. But I'm going to introduce our first speaker. He's incredibly bold. He's been fighting and fighting battles for a long time. He's going to open us in prayer and then say some words, and that is Pastor Jack Hibbs of Calvary Chapel, Chino Hills.
If you think about what we're being asked to consider as pastors and ministers, which is obviously the direction I'm coming from, we're being asked to take what the Word of God promises, that God changes. The Bible tells us, and it gives the list. Paul speaks to the Corinthians, a culture that was completely lost, a culture that was completely given over to whatever it wanted to do. And Paul goes down that list and he mentions all kinds of self-atrocities, that would be sins against self. And in listing all those things, he mentions these horrific things. He lists everybody, either in their actions or in their thoughts. He mentions, for example, in there, read it later if you'd like, homosexuality, among adultery and everything else. And then he says, and such were some of you. Listen, who are you today? Who are you today? You may not find yourself in a list of things that God disapproves of, but let me tell you something regarding that particular portion of Scripture. We've all sinned, the Bible says, and come short of the glory of God. We need the love of God. We need forgiveness. Every one of us live off the hope of being forgiven or forgiving another, correct? It's how we live as humans. And the Bible says we've been created in the image of God. God loves us. And listen, the LGBTQ community needs to know the love of God. Why would their hope be taken from them? Think of it. We have elected officials that want to take their will and impose it upon God's word, and for that matter, even the human heart. The human heart longs for change. So much of what you and I do every day is with the hope that something will be better. And that community that struggles with...
suicidal, depressed, hating myself, to encountering a living God that had solutions for me, which I found through my faith community. I found truth that changed me through teachings that I paid for, books that I read, books saved my life. Those books of hope, they are out there now, on the shelves now, today. They might not be January 1st, but they are on the bookshelves today. I found a counselor who I met with for every week for 5 years who kept me alive. He gave me hope. He told me, hey, you need to go and see that there are other people like you. He pointed me to a group of people who were coming out of homosexuality, and I met these awesome people who were just like me. They were out there, and some of them were further down the journey than me, and they had started dating someone of the opposite sex, and they were finding great fulfillment in life and feeling so proud of themselves for the change that they had experienced. Sex with a woman and am married to her because I fell in love with her. My life is not some experiment or some research project to try to prove, you know, assuming the future and seeing that today was going to happen and that this bill was going to come on the books, that I wanted to start pretending that I actually was sexually attracted to a woman and live with her the rest of my life. I married her 12 years ago because I fell in love with her. We have 4 children. We have a great sex life. I have issues, but homosexuality is not it. I have children, so I have issues. America is about, we get to choose who we are, we get to pursue it wholeheartedly, and if we want help with that, we get to get it. Do not allow anyone to convince you that this bill is about people's freedom or protecting people. It may be that someone thought that they were trying to help people with this bill, but I'm telling you, it only is helping a minority to the detriment of a super minority. We exist. There are 30 of us who testified this morning of change, of coming out of homosexuality and finding fulfillment in leaving that lifestyle. Not everybody has that story, but in America, that should be our rights. God bless you.
I think I missed the clean water rally.
Thank you, Ken, and thank you for everything you've been doing leading